In this video, we take a look at how to clean up and messed up workspace like this in Photoshop. Before we dive into the video, please don't forget to like and subscribe. And if you're ready, let's get into the video. Now, first things first, whenever you open Photoshop, this is the workspace you are presented to. This is the Photoshop CS6. This video will work for any of the current versions, 2019, 2020, either of them. But when you open Photoshop for the first time, you are presented to something similar to this. And the workspace has already been grouped for you, so you have a nice workspace. But the problem is, these ones that you see over here, you can actually move any of them, and anyone at all can reset this workspace. For instance, when you go to the top right here, if you are in CC, it is going to be that tiny icon over there, that tiny tab. You can click on that, and then you should be able to see these type of different workspaces. So you realize that currently we are in the essentials. When I pick the new in CS6, it is going to give me a different set of workspace. When I click on it again and I choose something like photography, everything has been arranged according to photography for me. And when I choose something also like the typography, it is going to give me something that is related to typography. And one thing that you notice is that for every one of these workspaces that you choose, it is going to give you a different set of arrangements. That goes on to tell you that you can as well make changes to this particular workspace. So if you are a couple of people, or you are in an industry and then you are working with the same kind of Photoshop, or you work on the same machine, there is a chance that your preferred workspace wouldn't be that equal to another person. So what the other person will do, for instance, if he is the photographer, is that when he is working in Photoshop, he will choose the photography workspace. So you're going to get your workspace messed up. Or perhaps if you have the typography guy over there, he's going to change the workspace. So for any of them, you are actually going to have a different workspace. Again, if you leave Photoshop for somebody who is not used to Photoshop, the person can totally mess it up. For instance, you can draw or drag this particular whole toolbox or the toolbar here and place it over here. The person can kind of, let's go to the essentials, he can drag this whole layer panel here, and then he can drag this again back. He can drag these tiles here, and then he can drag these tiles here. Let me know in the comment section if this has ever happened to you, whereby out of mistake or out of ignorance or something like that, you drag this all here and then you are stuck in Photoshop. When this happens, you don't really need to worry. All that you need to do is you go to this tiny box here. If you are in CC, however, it is going to be a different tab altogether, but it should work perfectly fine. So you click on the essentials here and then you go to reset essentials. Now you're back to the default. This is not the only thing that can happen to your workspace. This particular picture that I have over here, you realize that for any set of documents that you create in Photoshop, it will give you a different type of document. So for instance, Control plus N to create a new document. You're going to choose any type of paper and then I click OK. And then you realize that it has already given me a different type of workspace document. Now, sometimes you make the mistake of dragging this particular workspace and then you can drag it over here, right? So you realize that it is separated from this one. When it happens that way, sometimes you get tensed up, and then when you open it up like this, when you expand it, you realize that no tool for you to work out here. So what happens is that when it happens that way, you just have to drag it and then you can push it to the very top, but make sure that you have these blue lines around the corner, and then you can leave it over there, and then you see that it is back to default. In the same way, for your workspaces, you can actually set your own type of workspace by dragging, just like you realize that I was dragging this type of, that is the layer panel, to the top of my workspace. You can drag all of these things, all the panels, so you can drag this and drop it over here. The thing that you have to understand or realize that anytime you drag, you have to see this kind of blue indicating that it can place it over there, and then it fits straight into it. It can interchange all of these, so you can basically drag all of these ones, for instance, like this. So in this case, the idea is that I want to make my layer panel the first one, so I can drag and drop this to the extreme right here, and then it fits. Once you see the blue line, it means you can leave it there. And then you see that instead of the color swatches, my layer panel is the first one. Now I can go ahead and then I'll say that I want to make my adjustments layers the second one, so I can drag and drop it here. But you realize that the layer panel is up to this side, so what I have to do is I have to drag and drop it underneath here, and then I can leave it here. And then you see that it is next to this one. And the next thing that I can do is I can bring my color swatches at the bottom over there as well. So right over there, when you see the blue line, you can leave it there. And then I've rearranged the whole of my workspace. So the whole idea here is that I can easily have access to my layer adjustments over here. I can easily have access to my layers here, and these are the things that I barely use them, so I can just practically leave them over here. For these ones as well, you can just go to window and then you can add any of them that you want. Let's say the paths, I already have my paths over there, so you can click on the paths and then you add it to the layers. And anyone that is not in here, for instance action, you can just click on it and then it will be added to these ones over here. And one other thing, you don't want your tools to be just on a straight line like that, so you can click on this one and then you have it on two different lines. So this is the ideal workspace, or the customized workspace, for instance for myself. And I don't want somebody to just come and sit on here and reset all of these and I totally lose this one. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to Windows here, go to the workspace, and of course if you don't want to use this particular symbol over here, you can come to Windows workspace and use this one. So over here you have a new workspace, so you've realized that we've customized our workspace. So we go to new workspace, so workspace, new workspace, and then we can save this particular workspace. So you can, let me just give this name as the tutorial, because I'm doing this at the time of the tutorial. So tutorial, and you see that you can go ahead and then you save it. Now once it is saved, let's go to this small button over here again. So you can go ahead and go to the Windows over here, you have a new workspace. So let's choose something like the photography here, and then you realize that you are back to the photography. But when you go ahead and you go to workspace again and you choose tutorial, and you realize that we have the workspace that we customized. But if all of this still looks quite complex for you, you're just a newbie in Photoshop, you don't need to stress yourself. And if you find any of these things moved around, all that you need to do is you go to window, workspace, or you can use the little button over there on top. And then you can choose essentials. So you realize that essentials is default, and then you'll be back to default. Sometimes when you pick essentials, it doesn't give you this one. So what you do is you go to reset essentials, and then it brings you back to the first space, or the first workspace that Photoshop gives to you when you install Photoshop. I hope now you can set a new workspace for yourself. You can reset your workspace, you can move your workspace around, you can create your own customized ones. And then if you find things messed up like this, you don't need to worry so much. You just have to go to essentials and then you reset essentials, and then you'll be back to square one. The final thing that I want to talk about is when you have your tab key, when you hit on your tab key, sometimes you'd have something like this where you don't have any tool or any layer panel showing up. When it happens that way, hit on the tab key again and then you'll be back to default. I hope this video in one way or the other helped you. If it did, let me know in the comment section. This works for Photoshop CC, so you don't have to worry about trying it out. Thank you so much for sticking around to watch this video. Please don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. It's Innocent here. And bye.